Welcome to another TCPIP Basics course. In this particular video, we're going to talk about supernetting. Supernetting, kind of a cool word. It helps with routing. It cuts down on the routing statements needed, but it doesn't actually make any change to the subnets themselves. So it sounds kind of confusing, but let's take a look and see our graphic that we showed in a previous video. It shows our three different networks. We see the accounting network, the HR network, and the IT network, and they're all completely different networks. And they're connected by using a router or a layer 3 switch. Now, many people don't realize this, but you can turn a Windows server into a router. You just need to add the routing and remote access role and then configure it as a router. So we're going to use a Windows computer where we're going to add in our routing statements as an example. So let's say that we are in the 192.168.15 network and we want to route to the 192.168.1.0/29 or the 1.8 or the 1.16, or we want to go the other direction. Let's say that we were in the 1.0 network and we want to go to the 15 network. So what kinds of routing statements would we need that would allow us to use supernetting? Well, it's much easier to show you than to explain it ad nauseum. So let's go ahead and take a look at a demonstration of how we would do this. We're in our Windows server and we can see that we're on a 192.168.15.139 IP address. And our gateway out to the internet is 15.1. However, we want to route to the router, which is at 192.168.15.100. That is our gateway to the three subnets that we just saw in that graphic. So what do we do? Well, under normal circumstances, we would type in route add, and then we would put in the destination subnet. Then we put in the word mask, and that's for the subnet mask. So go ahead and put that in. Now, this is representative of a slash 29 that we saw in the previous video. And it gives us a total of 8 IP addresses, which are 6 of those are going to be usable. Let's go ahead and put in our gateway. So in this case, this gateway is our router, our Windows router that's at .100. So let's go ahead and hit enter. There we go. We did it. Excellent. That worked out great. Now we're going to add the second subnet. The second subnet, as you remember, starts at 8. And now we want to add the third one. If you remember, that's going to be at 16. Because there's 8 in each of these different subnets. Excellent. All right, so all this can be done using supernetting with a single command. So let me undo each of these three, and I'll show you how to do this with supernetting. You see, I've now undone all of those three commands using the delete in the routing command. All right, so let's go ahead and clear the screen. So instead of typing 3 commands, we can do this all with one. So we'll type in route add 192.168.1.0. And then we put in our mask 255.255.255.0. And then we put in our destination IP address once again. So the slash 24 encompasses all of those slash 29. So instead of typing 3 29 commands, I can do 1/24. In this case, /24 means this. And that is supernetting. Supernetting allows me to cut down in the amount of routing statements. So as you can see, I didn't do anything to the original networks. All I did was change the routing command, and that is supernetting. So I'll go ahead and hit enter. And there we go. I've now supernetted 3 different networks to route using one single command. This can also be done on a Cisco router or a firewall, but the syntax would be a little different than what you see here. So every operating system has their own slightly different syntax for that. Supernetting allows us to save time when configuring routing to other networks without making any changes to the networks themselves.